Hi. It's been a while, yes indeed, but I'm back, I hope. Anyway, let's make a quick transform real quick.
Cool, right? Anyway, hi. yeah, this is my new form because I feel like changing. And why not? Yeah, I'm gonna use my voice from now on because I got tired of using text-speech. It actually took a long time to edit it.
So let's not waste any time because time is money. And right now, we're going to edit this egg-looking face to this! Pretty and cute, ain't it? Say yes.
So let's get started with the tutorial. In this tutorial, we have 6 steps, which is
skin shading,
blush,
cheeks and lips detail,
eyeshadows,
eyes coloring,
and for the cherry on top, the filter.
Alright, let's start with the first step, which is skin shading.
Of course, we will start on creating a new layer.
Then change the blending mode to multiply.
So for today's editing, I'm gonna use some red orange-ish color because I'm going for a cute kind of edit. I don't know.
So yeah, we're using magic wand to select the skin and start coloring, I guess.
I'm not even gonna lie, this took a really really long time for me just to make the perfect circle for the skin shading. I don't know why, but it took me so long to make it.
It's probably because I'm recording, you know, artist problem where you stutter when someone records you.
Stop recording me, you're just a mistake.
IDK.
Okay, I know this looks weird now, but trust the process.
So this is how you're gonna unweird the coloring now?
Basically, you just need to change the opacity
of the layer.
And ba-bam!
See? Big difference. And now it also comes with good coloring. Okay, so let's just continue the coloring process because I'm not done yet with the skin. Anyway, let's go to the blush now. So basically, we're doing the same method with the first one, you know, add layer, go multiply, but this time don't change the opacity. And yeah, that's basically it. Oh yeah, and for the color, I'm using the color kind of orange skin-ish, you know. You can just copy mine, just pause it, screenshot it or whatever. I like this color because I don't know why, but it looks pretty in multiply. So yeah, I'm using it. I like pretty stuff. Oh yeah, and right here, I'm gonna make the second layer invisible first and then use the magic wand to select the skin so that, you know, when we add the blush, it won't add up to the eyes and only to the skin, so it's clean. And then now I'm gonna add a little bit on the nose so it looks like the character has a flu or something. But it's also cute, so why not, right? Oh, and in this part, I kind of forgot to add a little bit shadow under the eyebrows at the beginning. So I'm just gonna do that now. And I'm gonna use the same color, the same brush, same layer as the first one. So yeah, I'm just gonna make a triangle shape on eyebrows. And yeah. And now let's do the same to the other one. Bam. Okay, now let's add another layer, do the clipping mask, and we're going for the lips. And so for the lips, I'm gonna use a light pink color. I kinda want a tiny cute little lips for the characters, and I'm using pink because, you know, if you want something cute, then use pink. No, I just made a damn sorry. Alright, let's just do that and use the airbrush brush.
I'm gonna color the under lips only because somehow it looks weird when you try to color the upper lips. And then I'm gonna erase the excess. Now I'm just gonna be extra and add some details for under the lips so you can see the shape of the lips more.
Now I'm gonna add some highlights to the cheeks so she could look like Marin Kitagawa. So yeah, we're doing that. Okay, now let's make highlights for the lips. I'm just gonna erase some part. And yeah, that's basically it. Looking nice. Okay, now moving on to the eyeshadows. We're gonna add new layer, clip mask, and multiply. Dips layer. and then I'm gonna choose the same color as the skin shading color, and then create an eyeshadow that matches the eye shape.
Nice!
Okay, now let's do the same thing to the other eye. Okay, now she looks like OZ and Zero too. Let's adjust the opacity, and now we can remove the selected area. Alright, this looks nice already. Oh, and I forgot to add the blush detail, so yeah, basically just pick a darker shade of the blush and then add some strips, straight strips. And then remove the excess at the end. Okay, let's just now go to the eye shading part. We're gonna select the iris part with magic wand. Now let's add another layer and clip mask it and pick multiply. So we're gonna darken the iris first so it looks sexy. So pick a darker shade of your iris color and use some pen fade brush. And yeah, just start drawing, I guess. At this point, I'm gonna be honest, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just using my feelings to edit, yeah. Artisting, you peasant won't understand. I'm joking. Anyway, let's continue on. Now we're gonna add the circle oval thingy on the eye. If you see in a real eyes, there's this circle thing in
it's
the
called
middle.
Pupil.
So yeah, that's them. Now let's add a new layer and add a lighter shade of the pupil to make it look pleasing, I guess. I don't know why I add them. It just looks good, okay? Now in this part, I'm supposed to do it at the beginning, but I kind of forgot. But anyway, let's add a layer under the pupil layer and just color it the way you want it. Oh, and don't use the clip mask for that specific layer. So basically, you're making the base of the eyes shading. Now let's add a new layer and use add blending mode. And you know what that means. Shiny and shimmering part, not highlight though. Now let's choose the felt tip pen brush and yeah, start creating a small circle like that. So now let's adjust the opacity so it's not that bright. Okay, now let's add a new layer, clip mask it, and then use the dip pen hard brush. We're gonna create those pretty lines on the eyes, but much more simpler. Pick a color of your choice and make it more saturated. Now create these lines. Okay, now let's add a new layer, clip mask it, and pick add blending mode to add more shimmery to the eyes. Oh, and pick the color you chose before and then use airbrush brush. Nice. Now pick a brush called felt tip pen hard. Now this is the fun part. We're gonna add a new layer and make the blending mode add. Oh, don't forget the clip mask. Now we're gonna create some diamond shape on the eyes. Okay, trust the process, okay. Now we're gonna erase a plus sign on the diamond. Now it looks like the Windows logo. And adjust the opacity to your likings. Looking good. Okay, now for the highlights, add a new layer and then clip mask it. And then pick a white color and choose any kind of brush you want. And then, you know, just draw the highlight. Remember guys, too much highlight is ugly. We don't want too much, we need enough highlight. Oh, and I forgot to mention that in highlight, you don't need to clip mask the layer, so you can just undo that. Sorry. Okay, now let's go to add another layer for the eyeballs shading. Now select the eyeballs and clean up the selection layer. Oh, and I never use white for the eyeballs because the highlight is already white. So in order to make the highlight more popping, I need to use a darker shade for the background. So yeah, that's why I never use white for the eyeballs.
And for the eyeball shading, I use a blue and purple-ish color because, I don't know, it's pretty.
Now one eye is done, let's just copy and paste the other one because I'm lazy AF. We're a lazy teenager, guys. Let's just accept the truth. Now how do you do that is by merging all the eyes layer.
And remember to merge it in order or it will have different result and we don't want that. And now just duplicate the layer, flip it and adjust the eyes. And now for a cleaner look, use the special tool and liquify pen. Literally, this is my life savior. And just, you know, adjust them again. Ooh la la, it looks nice. And now for the eyeline part, I'm gonna select the eyeline with magic wand. Pick a brighter color and use the pen fade brush and start coloring it to brighten up the eyeline.
And now I'm gonna add another layer and pick the color pink peach-ish color, I guess, you know, just to add more dramatic color to the eyes because we love dramatic things.
Now let's add another layer and put it under all of those stuff. And we're making eyelashes, yay! And I'm kind of thinking of making circle shape eyelash because I don't know, I just have this feeling.
And let's use the top layer and then pick a blue bright color for the eyelash highlight.
And now let's just copy and paste it like we did before because we're lazy teenagers. But this is more like a work smart, not hard, so yeah, I am a smart person. Don't come at me.
And voila, we're basically done. Mwah, mwah. And
for the final step, of course, I didn't forget about it. The filter is optional if you want to do it or not, but you know what, I'm doing it because I'm extra.
So I'm using Fisco for this. It's totally free, you can get it in App Store or Play Store.
Take a picture and import it. Now let's go edit it.
First, I adjust the contrast, lower it to your liking.
Now I lower the exposure and then make the saturation higher.
And the most important part, the tone, make the shadows higher.
Now for the white balance, just adjust it the way your likings. Don't forget to always sharpen your edit.
Not too much though, or it will ruin your picture.
Okay, and there you have it. I think we should name this edit.
I'm gonna name this edit Winter Cherry because IDK, this edit just feels like it.
Anyway, if you're planning on attempting this Winter Cherry edit, feel free to tag me in this Instagram account and maybe I could see your attempt and comment it. So yeah.
Oh, and if you guys want a full-time edit, I made a video for that, so you can just click the link in the description.
So that's basically all for today's video, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed.